What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? Welcome back to another video. So a lot of you guys actually requested that I checked out the Painful Past Zodi. Alright? So I'm gonna be only reacting to a snippet of it. So if you guys haven't seen it, make sure you guys check it out after, link down below. But yeah, let's just let's go see what's going on here.
When Cody found out about the cheating, I just let Cody remember the exact day, the exact call that we had had. And I heard him say, "I found out what you did." And my heart dropped so fast. I was like, oh my God, like, cause I even forgot that it even happened, which is
That actually makes no sense right there, because if you forgot that it even happened, when Cody said, "I found out what you did," your heart wouldn't have dropped, because if you actually forgot, you would have no idea what he's talking about. So I'm just saying, I'm just gonna throw that out there real quick, all right?
Horrible. So when he had said that, I immediately grabbed my phone as fast as I could to try to speak to him. And I had dropped it into the water, and I picked it back up, and I was like, "Cody, like, I was literally saying I'm sorry so many times. I was like, you don't understand, like, we were already in a dark spot, and I wasn't thinking, because I was hurt and I was upset, and there's no excuse in the world for it." Like, I continuously told him that, and he was so hurt that he hung up, and I just cried in the bathroom, because I was scared of that I was going to lose him forever, he was going to find somebody else.
It was March 1st to March 3rd, and we broke up around March 12th, I think. And it was terrible. Me and Zoe both desperately needed each other, but we had to separate due to, you know, me being super controlling, to being insecure, Zoe being insecure, Zoe doing her own thing, Zoe wanted to make new friends, and I wasn't comfortable with that yet. So
Well, no, I don't blame Cody at all. You know, like, think about it. If you got cheated on, it would be so hard to trust your partner ever again, like, to be honest. Like, let's keep it real. You get cheated on, of course you're not going to want. And if you actually do go back to your girlfriend or boyfriend, of course you don't want them to have Snapchatting other guys or other girls. You know what I mean? It just makes sense. I mean, you got cheated on. Where's the interest, right?
Called her. I broke up with her. And it was hard for me, but I acted like it wasn't. I always act like I'm never hurt. I try to hide my true feelings, especially on camera.
Cody's a boy. Like, boys don't really show their emotions as much, but when Cody called me, he was crying. And I'd never seen him cry over a fight or anything, but he was hurt. And I could tell it in his voice, and I could tell it in his eyes that, like, he didn't know what to do.
Dude, do you know what's really weird? Cody and Zoe actually remind me a lot of me and my girlfriend, like, the way they are, like, a little bit, like, 2 years ago, because I'm 22, she's 21, they're, what, like, 19, 18, like, I'm serious, like, they're actually very alike to us. It's weird, it's really weird.
Even though, like, what I did was wrong, I could still tell he's so lumpy.
But we don't get this emotional.
But he was too hurt.
I always try to, now that I get out, people don't know that we were broken up for 2 weeks, and we still acted like we did. We still had videos together, we still kissed, yeah. We still acted as if we were dating, and people still don't know to this day. People think that we just, you know, we broke up, and they found out as soon as we broke up. Like, that's not how it went down. There was so many FaceTimes of, you know, "Cody, I'm so sorry, like, I want you back." And, like, so many conversations of me asking her what she wants me to do. I was giving her the power of, how do you want to handle this? Like, I didn't want the shooting game to get out. I was trying to protect her. Before the breakup went public, I was scarred. I didn't know what to do. I felt like I couldn't trust anyone. I sat in my room. I played video games. I didn't give up on social media, but I stayed away from it. I let my actual self heal and not act like I was letting myself heal. I was actually trying to be real with myself, because I'm...
Damn, bro, you know what? They're really mature. I respect that a lot. They really are, dude.
Yeah, my feelings. I'm the person that, you know, keeps my feelings inside. You'll rarely see me cry. You'll rarely see me talk about actually how I truly feel. So before...
That's like me, yeah. I don't tell anybody how I feel. Literally nobody. I don't.
Like,
if I feel depressed or anything, I just stay to myself and, yeah, I don't know.
Terrified. I was so scared of what was going to happen, because I knew that it was going to be a war when he and it completely was Zoe's fandom fought against my fandom. I kind of fought against hers. And there was really no winner. We both slandered each other, and it was a completely mistake to put it on social media. Even though I had control over it, I would 100% take it back, but I think it's better that people know. But I also think it's so damn stupid that people hate her for Zoe for the past 2 years that she cheated on me, because I forgave her, and I'm the one that went through it.
Exactly. You know what I mean? See, even though a lot of people are hating on her and all that, see, Cody at the end of the day loves her, and obviously if you love someone, you don't want to see them getting bashed online. You know, dude, he has a great point, man. I feel like I could relate too. Like, if me and my girlfriend broke up for like a crazy reason and people found out the reason and whether it was her fault or my fault, like if it was her fault and everyone online was like bashing her, I still wouldn't want that, because at the end of the day I still love her, you know what I mean? So it's like, I still love her, so I don't want to see people talking smack about her, like, no matter what, you know what I'm saying? Dude, he has a great point, man. Dude, this an emotional ass series, dog. But yeah, that's it for my reaction. I think, dude, it's crazy how mature they are. They seem very like grown and mature. And I like that, you know what I mean? They're not afraid to talk about their feelings, what they went through. It's really cool to see, you know, because there is a lot of couples on the internet who just act all happy in front of the camera, who put on a persona, and then behind closed doors, it's much different than that, right? So for them to actually sit down and talk about what has happened and like what they go through, it's really cool, man. And it just shows them, it just shows everyone that like, no matter who you are, how famous you are, how much clout you are, you have or whatever, you go through stuff. But like I said, most people keep that stuff off camera. So, I don't know, I respect that a lot. But yeah, that's my reaction. Thank you guys so much for watching, and peace.